Hello, good morning all. In the last class, we discussed what are abiotic things and what are biotic things. Okay, today we are going to study the interrelationship or the mutual relationship of these two things. That means biotic things and abiotic things. Okay, then all of you look your textbook, page number 12. You can see that page here. All of you look that. Clear. Then you can see biotic and abiotic factors in first column and second column, their interdependence. Clear. So first there is fish. In the first column you can see fish and the interdependence. All of you know that fish live in the water. Okay, so water is an abiotic factor, but fish is a biotic factor. So without water fish can't live. So fish and water is mutually interdependent. Clear. Then under point, feed on small organisms in the water, that you can see in your textbook. So fish is a biotic factor, water is an abiotic factor. Okay, so fish can live maybe in the pond or maybe in the well or maybe in the river or ocean or sea. All these are the abiotic factors of a fish, or we can say all these are the habitat of a fish. So if fish can live all these places, if there is only water. So by using water, fish can breathe. At the same time, water provides food for the fish. So that is the mutual relationship or interrelationship between fish and water. Okay, so I'm going to write fish here. All of you is that. So fish get air and food from the water. Clear. So fish get air and food from the water. So fish is a biotic factor and air and food is an abiotic factor. So they are mutually dependent. Okay, so one can live without the other. The first cannot live without the help of the second one. Okay, then next point you can see water. Water is an abiotic factor. Then what are the uses of water? Oh, how does water help other organisms? Then listen, provides dwelling place for many organisms. We can see that well is a habitat. Then pond is another habitat. Rivers are habitat. Streams are habitat. And you can see so many water bodies in our earth or in our surroundings. So all these water bodies, they provide dwelling place for many, many small and big organisms. So we can say water provides dwelling place to different types of organisms. Clear. So I'm going to write here, water provide house, or we can say habitat, or we can say dwelling place. Clear. Then third point, you can see here banyan tree that we already discussed. So banyan tree, we can take it as a symbol of tree. So what are the things trees provide for you or provide for us? I think third standard you have studied, trees are the bone of nature. Okay, so trees provide us food, trees provide for shelter, then trees provide rainfall. At the same time, trees take the excess fly of soil when there is heavy rainfall. Okay, all these are the important uses of trees. So I'm going to read here what are the important points. First one, makes the soil fertile. You know that if there is a big tree in your premises, the dry leaves automatically fell down and it mingled with the soil. So automatically that soil becomes so fertile one. Okay, so we can say the leaf of the trees make the soil more fertile. Fertile means good soil. In Malayalam we say phalapushtiyulla, nalla, good soil. Okay, so trees, plants, or sorry, leaves make the soil more fertile. So that is one important point that trees provide us. Next one, helps retain water in the soil. If there is no trees or there is no root in the soil, water cannot stand there. So water is prevented or checked by the root of the trees. Okay, so these are the important helps provided by the trees for all organisms. So that you study. Then next one, lotus. So lotus, you know that it's a biotic factor. And where does it live? Yes, it lives in water. So another point, lotus Lotus live in water. So, lotus is a biotic fighter and water is an abiotic fighter. Then another one, you know, lotus is a flower. So, there must be honey there. So, that honey is the food for bees and butterflies. Or we can say beetle. Clear? So, we can say that without water, lotus can live. So, this biotic and abiotic factor, they are mutually interdependent. So, because of that, these bees or butterflies or beetle can get their food. Clear? So, that's about lotus. Then, next one, you can see rock. So, rock is the best example for an abiotic factor because it is a non-living thing. But you know that rock provides shelter for many organisms. Because in some, the holes of some rocks, different types of rats, snakes, etc. live. So we can say rock provide shelter or dwelling place for many organisms. Okay, so in your textbook you can see a blank place there. So you please write what are the facilities provided by rock. First one, it provides shelter. So we can see rock provide shelter, or we can say it provides the facility to habitate. Clear? Then next one, another thing you can see air. Air. The importance of air, as you know, because air is very essential for all organisms because to breathe. For breathing, they need air. So you can write air provides facility to live. So air is also a non-living thing, or we can say an abiotic factor, and it provides facilities for all organisms for their life because air is very essential to breathe. Okay, the next one, frog. You know, this you can write breathe. The next one, frog. You know, frog, it lives in water and it can live on land. So land or soil is an abiotic factor, water is also an abiotic factor, but frog is a biotic factor. So frog gets its food from water and from the land. Okay, so in that case also we can see the mutual or interrelationship for the interdependence of frog and soil or water. Then next one, you can see water snake. In the case of water snake also, water snake lives in the water. It gets its food from the water because small organisms are there in the water and water snake feeds that small organisms. Clear? Then next one, light. It's very important one. Light, we can see sunlight. It is an abiotic factor. But this light helps organisms to see each other, to move, to catch its prey. So very important. I'm going to rub the some points here. So listen, what light is an abiotic factor. So what is the interdependence of light with other living organisms? They provide facility to see. Next one, to move from one place to another. Next one, to catch prey. P-R-E-Y, not P-R-A-Y. Prey means small organisms. Clear? So, light is an abiotic factor, and this abiotic factor helps the living organisms for what? To see, to move, and to prey, to catch prey. Okay. Then, next one, you can see tortoise. That's the same point of frog or water snake you studied. Then tortoise also lives in the water. It feeds from the water. The same point you can add there also. The next one, soil. Then that also you studied in the last class. Soil is very essential for what? Soil provides soil, a dwelling place for big trees, small organisms, big organisms, etc. So we can say soil is an abiotic factor and all others are biotic factors. So there also we can see the mutual interdependence between biotic factor and abiotic factor. Clear? Then last one, you can see that one point, vines. Vine. Okay, vine means, you have studied your lower classes, creepers and climbers. So we can say this vine as climbers. Climbers means they have this type of plants. They have weak stem. They can't stand straight without the support of other trees. So vines take the help of other big trees. Okay, so vines take the help of other trees. Big trees means shrubs, and they also provide food for some other small organisms, maybe insects or some other small creatures. So here also we can say the interdependence between biotic and abiotic phytos, all these sections we can take. Then vines also need the support or the help from soil. Okay, so in this box, you can easily understand what's the relationship between biotic phytates and abiotic phytates. Then there is an important point, the last part of your page number 12. That is an important word. Listen, it is known as ecosystem. Listen here, ecosystem. Ecosystem. Ecosystem means, now you studied what is biotic factor and what is abiotic factor. And in the last class, in the earlier part of this chapter, you studied what is habitat. So we can say it's a living habitat. We can, if you take any habitat, we can see these two factors, which are the two factors, biotic factor and abiotic factor. So ecosystem means the mutual interdependence of both biotic and abiotic factors of a particular dwelling place. So that is known as what? Ecosystem. So what is ecosystem? All of you study this very well. What is ecosystem? Ecosystem includes the mutual interdependence of what? Both biotic and abiotic factors. Clear? So these are the important points you have to study. So all of you, please fill up that boxes in your textbook and please study what is ecosystem. So once again, ecosystem means it includes the interdependence of both biotic and abiotic factors of a particular dwelling place. Clear? Okay, so remember all these points. Okay, now all of you listen, take next page. You can see a very beautiful picture here, the picture of a forest that you can see here. All of you look that. Okay, do you like the picture? Yes, it's a very beautiful picture of forest. What's the reason for such a beauty? Because forest is a wonderful place which includes different types of trees, different types of organisms, big animals, small animals, different types of birds, insects, etc. So besides that, there are different types of rivers, there streams, there ponds, there maybe waterfalls, there all these make all these natural things increase the beauty of a forest. Okay, now we are going to study what are the important uses of a forest. Okay, so all of you listen here. Uses of a forest, or how does forest help us? Last class you studied what are the uses of a tree. The same points you can add here. Some points you can add here. Okay, then first of all you say what are the uses of tree. First one, yes, they provide food for us. That means trees provide us fruits, trees provide us different types of vegetables, etc. So we can term that fruits and vegetables into one name, just known as food. So trees provide food for us, food for birds, food for animals, etc. Okay, so first point, what's that? Forest provide food for us. Forest provides food for us. Okay, then next point. Can you say next point? Yes, very good. Forests are very essential for rainfall. Forests are very essential for rainfall. Okay, then next one. Rainfall we get because of the presence of forest. Likewise, we will get good weather also. Okay, good climate. So we can write forest help us or influence our climate. Climate. If there is no forest, that means if there is no trees, our area or our surroundings will become desert area. Or that means it is severe hot. Severe hot. We can't suffer the sunlight. Okay. So trees or forests are very essential to influence our climate. Then You know that forests are the original places of a number of rivers. A number of rivers, because most of the rivers are originate or they start from forests. So forests are very important for us because they are the starting place or emerging place of rivers, streams, etc. Okay, streams, etc. Then you know so many valuable things. That means medicinal plants are there in the forest. So we will get different types of medicinal items. Okay, so we can say different types of medicinal plants available. Medicinal plants or medicinal things we will get from the forest. So many uses are there. You need not study all the points. You remember some important points only. Because forests provide us food, then forests provide us rainfall, then forests influence the climate of our country or our earth. Then forests are the starting place of rivers, streams, etc. Then different types of medicinal plants we will get from forest. Okay, then can you say any other point? Over. In the case of a tree, you studied in this voice. Okay, here also you need not study some more points because in your higher classes you will study more and more. Okay, so these are the important things you keep it in mind. What are the important uses of forest? Okay. Now I am going to wind up here. So please take down all these points in your notebook. Study very well. Okay, thank you.